The most important aspect of any ELISA kit is generating a clean standard curve. A curve starts with a unique top concentration and performs a series of serial dilutions down to the bottom concentration or sensitivity, which is the lowest concentration we can statistically distinguish from as zero. When you perform this step, make sure you truly mix each mixture so it's truly homogeneous, and eject the tip in between each standard. This makes sure that we were reporting the correct concentration for the calibration curve. Don't passage any antigen into the zero. It's a true zero. When plating any of the reagents, make sure that they are 1, the same temperature as the plate, 2, that you run the liquid down the side, 3, when it comes to your standards, eject the tip in between each standard. You don't need to eject this tip in between replicates. The IQELISA recommends running standards and samples in triplicate for precise and accurate measurements. Pay attention to your standard deviations, as this is traditionally a measure of user precision. We like our technicians to be well under a standard deviation of 1 for each measurement. Due to the tapered nature of the well, bubbles will likely form in wells with liquid. We need to remove them. You can tap the side of the plate to tap them out. Do not flick any individual wells with your fingers. We don't want any mechanistic force variation on the capturing agents. Incubations last for hours, so definitely keep them covered. Our lab does a quick spin on every step to make sure all the liquid volume is down in the well and there is no remaining bubbles left. This will help with your standard deviations. A 2-second spin will do, just turn it on and off. There you have it, folks. The most common mistake is not removing those bubbles. Bubbles beware. That and, oh yeah, we don't use a passive reference, so make sure that's turned off on the qPCR machine.